Hello friends, today I have discussed one point, that is the evaluation of drugs. At the time of evaluation of herbal drugs, which are followed the mainly two types of guidelines, such as first is the WHO guidelines and the second is the ICH guidelines. In that guidelines, it involves the how to evaluate your herbal drugs. So firstly, I will explain the WHO guidelines for the assessment of a herbal drug. So the basic information of WHO is, WHO means the World Health Organization, and the name indicate that it more related with the health and the diseases. So the WHO is specialized agency for the United Nations. It was established in 1948 for international health matter and public health. WHO has a wide area and the several functions, including the provision and reliable information in advance in the field of human health, mainly the WHO which are related to your health and the diseases. The WHO also deals with the disease as well as the give guidelines for the traditional and the herbal medicines. The following sections are involved for the assessment of herbal drugs according to the WHO to ensure the good quality of medicines. The first section, that is, gives the general introduction. That means it involves the general information of your herbal drugs. Then section 2, discuss the good agricultural practice for the medicinal plant. 3, discuss a good collection practice for the medicinal plants. 4th section, it will describe common techniques, aspects of a good agricultural practice for the medicinal plants and good collection practice for the medicinal plants. Then 5th section, it consider others relevant issues and guidelines to carry out to standardize the crude as well as finished herbal products which is provided by the WHO. These are the 5 sections which are involved into the WHO guidelines for the assessment of herbal drugs. So according to the guidelines, it include the various parameters and to check a various parameter at the time of assessment of drugs. Means you have to check the foreign matters, organoleptic and evaluation parameters, as well as the ash value, extractive value, volatile oil matters, moisture content determination, toxic contamination, microbial contamination, pesticide residue, radioactive contamination and the heavy metals. Means at the time of your testing and your assessment of herbal drug, it must be checked these parameters. So the silent feature of WHO guidelines are, there are mainly 4 guidelines for the assessment of drugs. First is quality assessment, second safety assessment, third efficacy assessment, and last is the stability assessment. So I will explain the step by step. And first silent features. First silent feature is quality assessment. In the quality assessment, it must be involved the following parameters. In the quality assessment, you have to check a different parameters. First, pharmaceutical assessment. In the pharmaceutical assessments, it involves the all information and all important aspect of a quality assessment of herbal medicines. In the pharmaceutical assessment, we have to study the monograph of each drug and each medicine according to the recent pharmacopoeia or the official pharmacopoeia. Means in the pharmaceutical assessment, you have to study the each and every drug or each and every medicines to the monograph according to the recent pharmacopoeia. For example, we have to select A drugs. For example, and these A drugs, firstly to check a quality of that drugs, and this quality of a drugs or the herbs which are checked according to the monograph, which is monograph present in the official pharmacopoeia or the recent pharmacopoeia. It is the first point covered in the quality assessment, that is the pharmaceutical. Then crude plant material. In that, we have to study or we have to involve information regarding the botanical name of drugs or herbs, including the genus, species, family, for the plant informations. In that, we have to also check the correct identification of a plant according to the authority.
okay, in that it should be involved the which part of plants which are provided in the medicinal properties, means involve the which part of a plants you are used for the study. For example, you have to select the leaf, flower, root, also include the fresh or the dried are used, means all information related to the plants, okay, and it should be also involve the chemical constituent and impurities like a microbial contamination. It is the second part which is present in the quality assessment. Third, the plant preparation. In the plant preparations, which involves the which plant formulations or the which plant parts are used, and this plant part gets converted into the which type of preparations, means you gets converted into the powder, tincture, extract, oils, juice, and the different types of preparation. So for the assessment of a drugs or assessment of a herb, to prepare a one preparations means to prepare a powder, tinctures, extract, okay, but at the time of these preparations or at the time of powder preparations or tincture preparation, the procedure should be described in details, okay, means you have to product a powder, we have to product a tincture, but procedures it is involve the all details informations. For example, we have to convert it into the tinctures. At the time of tinctures, which menstruum are used, it is also involved. Means the all informations are present in the plant preparations. Okay, and by these preparations are also identified by using the chromatographic finger printing to ensure the quality of the preparations. Means you firstly prepare a powders or tinctures. This powder and tinctures are gets identify and gets authentify by using a chromatographic finger prints. Okay. Next, finish the product. In that finish the product, the manufacturing procedure and formula including the amount of excipient should be described in details. Means we have to prepare a syrup. In that syrup involve the which type of excipients are used and the quantity of excipients are also mentioned. Okay, a finished product specification should be defined. Then the quality of finished product, it is very important parts, because the quality of finished products which are depends to the your manufacturing data, as well as this finished product it is a good, then gets marketed to the other or export to the your export to the your products. Okay, for the important finished product confirmed by the WHO certificates, means you have to, after the drugs are selected, after the plant part are selected, after the which procedure are selected, and after that you have to finish the product are prepared. But this all process for related to the quality assessment of a drug, but these are certified by only the WHO. In the simple things, you have to select a drugs. After that drug selection, which part are involved, and after that which part are in part gets converted into the which preparations, after that this preparation gets converted into the finished product. These procedures or this chart are mainly certified by the WHO. These four parameters are covered into the quality assessment of a drug. Then second guidelines for WHO, the which is a safety assessment. In the safety assessment, this should be cover all relevant aspect for the safety assessment of a medicinal products, and a guiding principle should be that a period has been traditionally used. Means you have to select a curcumin, but it is a traditionally used. So the basic information of curcumin, which is more related to your products. Means firstly to know the use of this herb in a traditionally. Then a review of relevant literature should be provided with original articles or reference to the original articles. Okay, as well as it involves the monograph and the review result and reported to the side effect should be documented according to the normal pharmacovigilance practices. For the safety assessment, it involves the two types of a study. In simple things, safety assessment means what? Means you have to select a one herb. Firstly, you check a quality, then you check a safety. At the time of safety, you select which type of herbs to know more the information related to this type of herbs. We know more information related to the herbs. For example, you select a curcumin syrup or curcumin cream. So to all of you know related to the curcumin uses, which is traditionally used, and to search a literature survey means to search in a curcumin creams are used, as well as to search a curcumin syrup are used, and your formulation and literature survey formulations are compared and to determining the safety, and the sum of side effects are present in your formulation, these side effects should be also documented. Okay, and for this safety assessment we have to study the two types of study, such as toxicological study, and second is documentation of safety based on experience. First is toxicological study. In the toxicological study, it is also part of a safety assessment. Means you have to check the toxicity of your formulation. Then the safety based on the experience. It involves as a basic rule, documentation of a long period of use should be taken into the consideration when assessing the safety. Means your formulations, which is a more strong documentary, means it is a long period of time, it should can be increased or it should can be in used as considering the safety assessment. This means when there is no detailed or toxicological study documented, the documented experience, long term use without evidence of the safety problem should form the basis of the risk assessment. Even in case of drugs used over a long period of time, which is a chronic toxicological risk, may have occurred but may not have been recognized. If long-term traditional use cannot be documented or there are a doubt on the safety toxicity, so the data should be submitted. Means your formulation are prepared, but your formulation, we know said it is 100% safe, but these your formulations submitted to a particular authority persons to take the toxicological studies, and after the toxicological study you have to mention a report, and for the long period of a drugs or the long period of a formulation, it should be produced as a sum of toxic effects are produced. So for long term of traditional uses cannot be documented. It should not be documented, but there are doubts on the safety toxicity which also produces, and they can be submitted. Okay, it is the parameters you have to check a safety assessment. Then the efficacy assessment. In the efficacy assessment, this should cover all information aspect of efficacy assessment. A review of the relevant literature should be carried out, and copies provided of the original articles or proper reference made to the thems. Means at the time of your preparations or the formulation, your literature survey with you, it is necessary. Means when you print out the 100 papers related to the curcumin creams, so this literature survey must be present with you, and these are compared with your articles. And this your literature survey which act as a reference. Then research study, if they exist, should be taken into the accounts. Following activity check for the efficacy assessment, and at the time of efficacy assessment to check a following parameters. First is activity. At the time of activity means you have to study the pharmacological and the clinical effect of active ingredient and their constituents with a therapeutic activity should be specified or the described. Means after, at the time of formulation, you have to must be check the efficacy of your formulations, and at the time of efficacy we have to check a pharmacological and the clinical effect of an active ingredient and their constituents with a therapeutic activity. Okay, and your therapeutic activity should be specified or the described. Then evidence required supporting indications. In the evidence required supporting indications, it involves the combination with both products. In that, the combination of your both product means generally herbal medicines are sold as a combination of several active ingredients along with the traditional remedies. Means when you prepare a curcumin cream, in that curcumin cream it is your traditional preparations, and after that the traditional preparation you have to also combine with the other active ingredients. In this case, assessment should be differentiated between the old and the new combination products. This clearly means there should be proper assessment of old and the new combination separately. Okay, means you have to prepare a one formulation, your formulations are compared with the older formulation, but the same formula are used, or the different formulas you use to check efficacy of your product and efficacy of old products. Okay, for example, in 2020 your batch are prepared the curcumin cream, and last year 2019 the one batch we have to prepare a curcumin cream. So these two, old batch and new batch, their two formulations are compared and separately data are prepared. Okay, in case of herbal drugs from traditional medicine, classify the text of Ayurveda, traditional Chinese medicine, Yunani or Siddha medicines. The experience can be used as evidence of efficacy. At the time of your formulation, the experience, it must be used for the evidence. Whenever the new combinations are used, should explanation about the effective dose and the compatibility involves. Means you have to express your product is good as compared to the older products. Okay, the herbal drugs containing the new ingredient should be required clinical studies to show the efficacy. Means after the formulation, it must be prepared or it must be check a clinical studies of your formulations, which shows the efficacy. Last part for the WHO guidelines is stability. According to the WHO, it has given the guidelines for checking the physical and chemical stability of the product in the container in which it should be marketed. Stability should be tested under the defined storage condition. The shelf life should be established. In that points, mainly you have to start your formulations. Means that you have to start the herbal formulation to check four parameters such as quality assessment, safety assessment, efficacy assessment, and the stability assessment. In simple things, in the quality assessment, you check your product, that is your herb, your active ingredients are must be quality or must be checked by the experienced person. After that, you have to check a safety. Means your product, it is more safe, you have to check according to the WHO guidelines. After that, you have to check a efficacy. In that efficacy, you have to comparison in between the old and the new formulations or the combinations method. And last is the stability. After your formulations are prepared, it must be stabilized for a longer period of time, and it must be stable for the longer period of a time. So it must be check a stability study of each and every herbal formulation. So first part will be the covered, that is the WHO guidelines for the assessment of drugs. Thank you.